24-hour project is, God bless you. 24-hour project is where we make shows, we write shows from the scratch, we build everything from the ground up in 24 hours, surprise, surprise. So, we write the shows, we have directors look at the shows, direct the shows, pick the cast all learns the lines and the blocking and everything.
Tech created this beautiful
thing. They created everything, yes. So, all overnight. So, for most people it's 24 hours, for us it's like 40 maybe, depends, so many other hours. But yeah, so 24-hour project, we get it all done, 24 hours. 24. That is the thing. All right, so.
For every year we do 24, we pick a certain theme and a certain location for each of the writers to base their stories off of. So for this year, our theme was truth. Our location was my uncle's basement. So that's where we are currently. Welcome to your uncle's basement. So, also throughout the night, while the writers are writing, we throw them three, I believe, other curveballs, a prop that they have to move, an action or movement that they have to move, and a phrase or line that they have to move. So, search throughout all of the shows for common themes, see if you can come out, and we'll reveal
the
anyone
to pay attention. It's like a weird small 24-hour project. One of those small
so
though.
One day.
Alright,
so what else do we have going on tonight?
We have our giveaway. So, we have gotten so many donations from the community, from different businesses, and even our local UWEC theater department who has donated stuff to us. And we're going to give away it, as the title implies. So, outside those doors, you might have seen like this little silver, what is this called? A bowl? It's a bowl. A little silver bowl. And we're giving out blue tickets. It's not the blue tickets you got when you went to the box office. We were surprised at that. But there's someone out there who is giving out tickets. So, go get a ticket. It is free, absolutely free. You don't have to pay for anything, you don't have to do anything. You just go and you get the ticket, and at intermission, I think at the end of intermission, going into the second act, we will be calling off fabulous prizes, which we will announce a little bit later. So, at intermission, go out there, get your tickets. It is literally free. If you don't get your tickets, I sometimes just question people. So.
All right, moving right along. We are about to get started with the performances of 24-hour project. Up first is a show called The Stash, written by Lauren Hogan and directed by Mike. So, yeah, ready for that?
Yeah. Let's get this puppy started.
You're a quizzer, Harry! the movie. Duh. You know, there's like a big hairy dude and he like, you know, gives the kid cake and takes it to some school, takes like a, some magic tests and shit like that.
For the amount of times that I've made you watch the Harry Potter movies, the fact that you still get the iconic quote to Harry Potter boy wizard wrong is insane.
Potato, potato. You know, goes to school, learns magic shit. It's like the same thing, potato, potato.
It's potato, potato.
No one pronounces it potato. It's potato, potato. You know, because like all potatoes are the same thing, and they're all root vegetables. They're like, because they're all saying it at the root. It's a metaphor!
Oh, Danny, you have such a special brain. Oh, look, it's a picture of young Grandma Ruthie.
Oh, there she is.
She's so beautiful. She could have been a model, honestly.
Didn't she? I remember her saying that she dabbled in photography or something like that in her 20s.
Oh, that's right. She brought that up at dinner tonight.
Yeah, she did. She said it wasn't usual for her to pose with her legs so crossed, which was really weird.
I mean, I guess, but, well, she's kind of old, so, like, crossing her legs would be kind of uncomfortable. But, gosh, she's beautiful. I mean, look at those.
My father. I have a copy of doesn't know.
Well, obviously it's better if he doesn't know.
Jesus, why was this out here in the first place?
Shut up!
He knew we were hosting Thanksgiving this year.
Make me come over there. Sigh.
What about you? Where are we?
My uncle's basement.
Whose uncle?
Mine.
Who's you?
Me.
Who's me?
Not you. Me.
All right, me. Well, I didn't command you to speak. So who are you?
Me.
Strange. I wasn't expecting any visitors tonight. Also, how can you speak without permission? Come on. You can speak. Tell me what's happening.
I can't move.
I know that. Stairs. I didn't tell you to do that. Sorry. I didn't tell you to speak either.
He can't move.
It's your turn to lay on the floor.
No, it isn't. This isn't where we are. We're in Riverside. And it's a 24-hour theater project. Oh man, next time you see me, I might be somewhere else or someone else with a different script. I'm not gonna tell you anything about this show. In fact, you just kinda have to accept our nothingness. Find truth in our lack of truth. Then, since I'm monologuing, someone probably drug this. All right, let's get started.
Sir?
Who's sir? No one's speaking.
Not him.
It's not me.
Do you know about fourth wall?
All three of us are vaguely aware of it, yes.
Two. I'm not here. I'm not a character.
Whatever that means. All right, we have plenty to do. Have you read your lines?
Lines?
My arms are getting tired.
Well, you can put them up when I'm done.
I can't move.
I'll deal with you in a minute. Here, take this.
What do I do with it?
It's a script. Now read.
The characters.
Oh.
In this.
Production.
Production.
Do not
have names.
Names. They.
They are in the script.
According.
Doing at the start of the show. Excellent. Good. Go on and study it.
Move me.
What?
So, what now?
Time to... explore! Cue music! This is the madness of men. My Trans-Siberian Orchestra.
Thank you.
saying before?
Yeah, something about finding truth. What does that mean?
Well, I think it means... I think it means us finding ourselves as people, individuals free to control, as characters on the stage, fulfilling their roles. And take a look at this place. We are suspended in time, in space, in animation, in this ethereal and theatrical plane. And just think of all the real people out there. They can only do so much as their environment allows them. Meanwhile, and here, well, we just have to leave it up to the winds of fate.
Oh, I'll be feeling that in the morning.
Welcome back!
Smell the charge?
If the script says so. You all think you're so clever, don't you? Trying to change things, trying to grow and develop.
Well,
this is theater. The only thing that's concrete is the script, and you guys had that in your hand the whole time, didn't you? You didn't even know the ending! You're all so stupid!
Is that just how you were written?
Now, after me. To tell the truth, all the truth, nothing but the truth. The truth is nothing. Truth.
Truth.
Truth. Truth.
Truth.
Truth. Truth. Truth. Truth. Truth. Truth. Truth. Truth. Truth. Truth. Truth. Truth. Truth. Truth. Truth.
Was haunted.
Or the time she told him that Bigfoot lived in the woods out back and he only ate blueberry pancakes.
Or the time he lit firecrackers outside her window on the 4th of July. Check this out. Want some?
How long has that been down here?
I think the better question is how long has it been open? Best Buy, January 20th, 1991.
That's so gross, don't eat it!
Relax.
February
14, 1996. Isaac, I've been thinking.
thinking a lot about what happened the last time we met. And it's shown me that while we love each other, we aren't meant to be together. The arguing, the fighting, the pain we cause each other, that's not how I want to spend the rest of my life. I'll find someone who will make me happy. Eventually, you will too. We'll go our separate ways. We'll have families of our own, and we won't need to see each other again. The world will keep spinning, life will go on, and it'll be okay. As for the children, I want them to be with someone who can give them everything. So I talked to Lisa. I trust her to raise them as her own, and when the time comes, I'll be signing over all my parental rights. Whether or not you decide to do the same is up to you, but think about what's best for them. Your sister will be a great mother. You won't have anything to worry about. I'll be changing addresses soon, so please don't send any more letters. Don't expect any more from me. Wishing you the best, Catherine.
Is she talking about?
Who else could it be?
Why didn't she tell us?
Who knows? Does it really matter?
Of course it matters. Why wouldn't it?
Well, it's not like we have anybody to go to get answers. We don't know anything about this Catherine person. Uncle Isaac's been dead for years, and we can't exactly go to Mom on the other side for help. Why should we waste our time looking for someone who didn't even want us in their life to start?
This Catherine person is our mother! You're not the slightest bit curious what she's like.
I think I know enough.
What if she has a family?
So what?
So what? So we can have other siblings, other cousins, other aunts, uncles, other grandparents.
Alice, if she wanted to know us, she would have looked for us. She would have found us. What part about signing away parental rights do you not understand? I bet you that she never even told anybody else that we exist. She's not our family, and we're not her family. So just let it go.
Look, I'm sorry. It's an emotional day for both of us. If you want to look for Catherine, I won't stop you. Tell you what, I'll go with you to that trivia night thingy you like.
You'll have to wear the team shirt.
Not the one that...
Say it. I'm sorry.
You're a quizzer, Harry.
You know your pain, right?
On a completely different topic, back to the giveaway. So, after this next show, there will be an intermission, 10-minute intermission, and that's the perfect time to go get your free, I repeat, free ticket to get prizes, fabulous prizes, in which you don't have to pay anything. I'm going to keep repeating that.
Is this what that means?
Yes?
We also have a $70
that you do need to pay for, but
it's only $1.
Exactly, so...
Almost free.
Yeah. I was going to say something, but I was going to say I'm a hollow for a dollar, but I
can't.
All right, and then our last show for this, I'm sorry, act, I said semester, our last show is entitled Mozzarella. It is written by Tim Wollman, and it is directed by Cassie Klinga. Enjoy, and yeah, have a good intermission, yeah.
See you later.
Girls at all.
Maybe not girls plural.
What?
Oh. Nothing.
right? What we have going is great. I love hanging out with you guys.
Hey, I do too. None of that's going to change when you two are making out half the time.
Shut up.
I promise. By the end of tonight, you two are going to be cuddling on this couch, and it's going to be fucking adorable.
Yeah, me too. figured it's about time I told the two of you. I mean, 3 for 3 with this group of ladies, am I right?
Hell yeah!
I'll turn to that.
Oh, there's the snake skin. I'll be right back.
Hey! Emily, what the fuck? Can't you see that she was so uncomfortable with that? You know, some lines just shouldn't be fucking crossed.
Hey, she's fine. Well, except for the sticks. But anyway, now you know you had a shot. I saw how excited you were to hear about it. Now take it.
She could have been talking about anybody.
God fuck, really? Why else would she be so nervous?
I don't know, okay? She was uncomfortable with the situation. Hey, how you doing?
Good, I'm fine.
Okay, there's nothing we need to unpack or anything?
No.
Okay, good. Good. Good, great.
Shit, I forgot to put Reese. Hold your breath, it's toxic in there.
Well, you needed a push.
Yeah, and they could push me off the goddamn Grand Canyon.
Giveaway, it feels a little light, but that's okay.
Our fourth prize is here.
Oh, prizes.
to 3 free entree cards to Barachos.
Thank you.
try to get laid and it didn't work. So, let's try to figure out where the hell we are. Oh my god, we have to figure out where we are!
My name is Brock, and this is Dallas May. Call me the uncle. Welcome to the basement!
There's no way in hell I'm calling you uncle.
Listen up, pussy ass bitch. Establishment of misused energy for new technology. The basement.
Wow. How long were you behind that couch?
I do not quite know, but to be honest with you, I really did go to town on this bag of chestnuts.
Okay, well, what does this agency that you work for do exactly?
Glad you asked. Thank you. So what we do is we take the misused energy around the world, like, let's say a person's appliances or lights they didn't turn off when they left their house. We are able to access that technology, and we're able to turn it into new technology that can really just save the country.
Wow. That sounds like totally impossible and ridiculous, but like, I'm so in. What kind of time experience do you
have? Not to tell you, because he assigned the keepers, but under no circumstances will you reveal the information shared, unless you want to be tried with treason.
Seems like some crazy conspiracy shit. I'm in. Mm-hmm.
I thought you could have that. Here you go.
Oh, you want my autograph? Oh, of course, I'll sign it and call my fiance.
Thanks. I'm so glad that you decided to trust us. Your commitment to the betterment of our agency is greatly appreciated.
Whatever, man, I'm just here to do for your shit. Oh my god, I'm so excited! Oh, I just peed a little bit.
Against Nazis, and it's insanely easy to use. All you need to do is point at the target, and then you press the button, and boom, a very large, powerful ray will cause unimaginable harm.
That's a normal flashlight. I don't even think any of this is real.
Ah! Oh, wait, there's the little kinks that we have to still work through, but Did you know that he can bring and he can channel other spirits? But you can only choose one, so if you want to talk to one, good chance.
Dude, can you stop with the fucking spy bullshit?
Can you stop with your attitude?
Okay. Fuck it. Let's do it. What do I do?
All you need to do is hold it, and you have to say a phrase to attract the one that you want to call.
Don't watch. I call upon my late father, Harry. You're a quitter, Harry! You will never be forgiven for the abuse that you gave me as a child. How dare you do this to me? I was your father. I took care of you, and all you did was use me for financial abuse. Ugh, burn in hell! Fuck you, Dad! Well, look where you are now! You're a literal dummy, just like you were in life. Oh, I'm a dummy. Well, I wasn't the one that got hurt when I was 15, so then decided to fuck the entire football team. Very aggressive. The next one is That would have been pretty epic. We tried to stage, but...
Sure would.
The next is a long-ass handshake. Did I ever say that?
No,
long-ass handshake. And the last is Skippy with three questions.
There's also a lot of dancing.
Very specific,
too. What's the one with the love shack dance?
The love shack dance? Never heard of that. It was just
in
song. Props to you.
Sorry, I'll make a joke, but never mind.
What is our next show?
Our next show was written by Lil Brian. I know he's here, but I don't know where he is.
Oh, there
he is! Hello! And it was directed by Lucy Weld. And she's here too as well. And the title is, because I don't speak English very well. Wait, what's the title?
Verisimilitude? Did I get that right?
To live is to thrive. To live. And
also believe that life had no meaning, so there isn't.
That's where you're wrong. He fucking hated nihilists. We need to believe in something. That's what we thought. Do you remember that book you read in high school? Albert Camus?
The Myth of Sisyphus?
Yeah. I'll read it this morning. Listen to this. I leave Sisyphus at the foot of the mountain. One always finds one's vertigo, but Sisyphus teaches the higher fidelity that negates the gods and raises rocks. He too concludes that all is well. The struggle itself toward the heights is enough to fill a man's heart. One must imagine Sisyphus is happy.
Fuck. Fucking hell.
What?
You're passionate. Me, not so much. I'm just a bum.
And you go to work. You have a job.
Odd jobs? I can't keep one to save my life. You know what? I need another drink. You want something?
Whoa. You sure you want to get twisted right now?
Fuck you. Have a drink.
What's up, man?
I want to have a drink with my best friend. That's what's up. I come here to escape what's real.
And you're not going to do that by escaping into a lot.
Fuck you! All your pathetic one-liners and religious nonsense.
I'm sorry, but I am in a living hell. I am stuck in my uncle's basement, trapped in my own rabbit holes. My eyes glued to the goddamn TV, fretting over infomercials. This is hell.
I love that. You don't have anyone breathing down your neck but yourself. Grow up. I'm fucking Sisyphus. I'm pushing this rock up this goddamn hill by myself.
Emma. I'm
sorry? Yeah.
Maybe you should be taking yours.
Maybe you should be taking yours. Hey, I accept your apology.
I know, Ev. Don't worry about it. Let's just chill out, alright? It's a good audience.
Yeah, play that New Order song that we used to always listen to. You have it on vinyl, right?
Yeah! Leave me alone. I was just thinking about that.
This isn't a joke. police or anything. He's already giving you the money, but what's your story?
I'm Cece. I'm desperate.
What's new?
Shit sucks. I'm in a hole that I cannot dig myself out of. And this is my only option.
Only? Maybe I understand you more than you think.
It's a struggle, but I swear to God, as soon as I'm done with this life, I am never coming back.
One must imagine Sisyphus is happy.
What?
Never mind. Have you heard of Reacher Nitro?
Who?
He fucked a prostitute and died of syphilis. Hated his own philosophy. Truth is power, or something like that.
Sorry, never heard of
that. Never mind. Just thinking out loud. Regarding my other point, here.
Miss of the Sisters, read this.
Why?
There's power in swords. Here.
Thank you. I mean, what the hell? You guys are some of the nicest, strangest people.
Get out of here!
We knew her.
We did?
Cece, Cecilia, from high school.
Oh. Homecoming queen, Cece. Rich, Cece. Parents driving around in a Lambo, Cece.
Yeah.
But we know.
Put that song back on.
Yeah, sure, man.
Don't fuck.
She is such a slut. I mean, I don't mean to be slut-shaming, but she's a slut.
Well, I'm Teresa Caputo, Long Island medium, and what I'm sensing is jealousy.
Shut up.
Hey, I'm just telling you what I heard from the beyond. She wants you to know it wasn't your fault.
Do I ever tell you how much I hate you?
All the time, actually. So, I mean, do you like him? What's going on with this guy? I mean, have you talked to him?
So many questions! God, you're a quizzer, Harry!
Tell me everything.
There's nothing to tell. I mean, I know he doesn't like me.
I always say that.
This basement is kind of nasty. No wonder Chaz didn't want anyone to come down here.
Well, I mean, it's eerily peaceful. With the party going on, nobody knows what we can do down here.
Well, anything
would
happen.
Oh, God. God, you're disgusting.
You're gay.
Old facts.
Oh, phew. I was worried because I saw the basement door open.
Oh, not next time.
Yeah, we're having sexual intercourse.
Yeah, you guys go together like turtles and plastic straws. Just come upstairs.
Fine.
Come on upstairs.
Teresa, what do you think?
Oh, I think Chaz is hiding something.
Interesting.
Shut up.
Why don't you want us down here anyway?
Because it's, because it's haunted, okay?
Wait, are you serious?
As serious as the Survivor season finale.
Yes.
Yes, I did. I saw my cousin Rhombus into the air.
Your cousin Rhombus?
Yes. He's in great shape.
I only see one viable option.
Please don't say
a Ouija board. I mean, look, it's an old shit.
Salutations? Are we trying to talk to the pilgrims?
Oh,
are here, please make your presence known.
Damn, did you just see that?
You probably just laughed again, didn't you?
No, I swear.
Okay, well, who's moving it?
Nobody's moving it.
What's it saying?
back to the event. And now we would like to bring out our cast and crew for this event. Please come out. Okay.